Thank you. we come together to praise God, that we can be reminded that God always offers each of us the gift of forgiveness and peace, that God is the one who never tires of forgiving us. Even in the moments when you and I are tired of ourselves and tired of the ways that we continue to fall short, God's love for us always endures. And so, my friends, as we prepare to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us first pause to call to mind ourselves and to ask again for God's pardon.
Whoa.
falling to his knees, Instead, he had a fellow servant put in prison until he paid back the debt. Now, when his fellow servants saw what had happened, they were deeply disturbed and went to their master and reported the whole thing. His master summoned him and said to him, "You wicked servants, I forgave you your entire debt because you begged me to. Should you not have had pity on your fellow servants as I have pity on you?" Then, until he should pay back the whole debt. So will my heavenly Father do to you, unless each of you forgives your brother from your heart. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise.
It's definitely a beautiful morning for us to be gathered here in our sanctuary, gathered virtually in this moment for our worship today. That we gather together to continue to celebrate, as we've been saying since we celebrated our revival, that we have a God that is worth praising, because we have a God who is still blessed. That even if everything that's continuing to go on in the world around us, with everything that each of us have going on in our own lives, we come here to praise God for the gifts and the blessings, this presence of a God who calls us, assembles us to be gathered here in worship this morning. That's why it's a blessing for us as a parish. And whether we're here in the sanctuary or connected virtually in this moment, it's an opportunity for us again to be here in the house of the Lord just one more time. To be gathered together as a community of faith, just celebrate everything that God is doing in our midst. You know, our reflection since March, when the pandemic really began, has been about how we are called to continue to be church. Whether we're here in the church or we're worshiping from outside the church, you and I are called to be church wherever it is that we find ourselves. Well, recently, that's why our focus together as a parish has been on radical hospitality. We've been focused on how it is that God is calling us to first relate to one another that are here in the sanctuary, and then to relate to those that God would call us and lead us to encounter outside the walls of this church. I hope by now that we've heard Mark and Jennifer and I reminding us in heaven that we are called to be a people of encounter, of accompaniment, and witness. That these are the marks of us as missionary disciples of Jesus. These are the marks that you and I are called to be living as we seek to be imitators of Jesus in our world. These are the marks of how you and I are called to be followers of Jesus. As you've heard us say over and over and over again these last weeks, Jesus is the model of radical hospitality. Everything about Jesus is ministry, everything about his mission, everything about his life shows us what radical hospitality is meant to look like. What it really means to encounter people where they are in life and to love them completely. To love them for who they are, and to love them where they are, and to love them enough to call them to a life of greatness. Because that's exactly what Jesus has done for each of us. That's exactly why you and I are gathered here together on this Sunday morning, because we recognize this great call that Jesus has placed upon each of our lives to be the ones entrusted with this mission of building the kingdom of heaven right here on our earth. That's why radical hospitality, it isn't something that we're just going to focus on for a minute and move on to something else. This is our sacred responsibility as baptized believers in Jesus. That's why it's not reserved to just a few. It's why there isn't some new community here in our church. Although us church folk do love a good community, amen. But we recognize that this call of living radical hospitality is meant for every single one of us who are baptized in the name of Jesus. That we share this responsibility. Thank you.
Thank you.
So as we come to the altar today, as we gather to receive this gift of Jesus in our lives once again, let's be reminded of the power of the forgiveness that God shares with us. And to be reminded that is the great gift that you and I have to share with one another. It's when we hold unto Jesus that we have the power to change the world. So who is it that you're holding out to?
Yeah.
son, died in his family. He descended into heaven. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of sins, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of God, and life everlasting. Amen. Is this God who promises to be with us? This God who desires to dwell among us, to be a part of everything that we have to face, who hears us, who knows our needs? And so it is with faith and trust that we bring our prayers and needs before our loving God.
Father, that we may be alive with forgiveness and mercy in a world that shouts out to our neighbors and retribution. We pray this to you.
Lord, we are praying.
For world leaders, that they may take their justice and mercy as they enact and enforce the laws of their land. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, we are praying.
For our grandparents,
gracious and loving God, we thank you today for this gift of your reckless love. We thank you, Lord, for being who you are. We thank you for being the God who is able, the God of mercy, the God of compassion, the God of forgiveness. We thank you, Lord, for never letting up on any of us. And so we ask you, God, to fill us again with the gift of your Holy Spirit, to strengthen us with the courage that we need so that we might be your imitators in our world. Fill us with the gift of your very self, so that in everything we do, we continue to share your mercy, your compassion, your kindness, your love with those we encounter. We thank you, God, for the blessings that you shared, for the prayers that you answered, and for everything that you promised to do, as we pray together in Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So we know that our ministries wouldn't be possible without our time and without our giving. We know that God loves a cheerful giver. So again, thank you for your generosity, the ministries of St. Columbanus. If you'd like to, you can text God Giving to the number 773-900-7211. Make its way that you can give to New Central. You can visit our parish website, click on Ways to Give. You can drop your envelope in the bin that's there near the front doors of the church on your way out today, or you can always mail your offertory to correction. But it's together when all of us sacrifice for the blessings that God has given us, that together we can plant seeds in the ministries of our church. Thank you for your time. Thank you for your generosity. Look with favor on our supplications, O Lord, and in your kindness accept these, your servants' offerings, that when each has offered to the honor of your name, they serve the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just that we should always give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you do not cease to spur us on to possess a more abundant life, and being rich in mercy, you constantly offer pardon and call on sinners to trust in your forgiveness alone. Never did you turn away from us. And though time and again we have broken your covenant, you have bound your family to yourself through Jesus, your Son, your Redeemer, with a new bond of love so tight that it can never be undone. Even now, you step before your people, a time of grace and reconciliation. And as they turn back to you in spirit, and you grant them hope in Christ Jesus, and a desire to be of service to all, while they entrust themselves more fully to the Holy Spirit. And so, filled with wonder, we extol the power of your love, and proclaiming our joy at the salvation that comes from you, we join in the heavenly hymn of countless hosts, as with our hand, we acclaim.
Thank you.
the mystery of faith. Deliver us, Lord, we pray for everyone. Graciously grant peace in our needs. That by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessing and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. In gracious may the peace of the Lord be with you.
The Lord.
May the word of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies, so that its effects, not our own desires, may always prevail in us through Christ our Lord. Let's thank heaven to mind and mark for ministering to us. And of course, we want to thank our awesome vocalists, Doris, Beatrice, and Ben Florida, for ministering to us. You know, we're blessed here at San Pablo Vegas that not only are we a teaching parish for Bundle Life Seminary, we're given this awesome responsibility to continue to help form Matthew and Elliot as they prepare for priesthood. We're also a ministry practical site for Catholic Theological Union. And so I'm excited to introduce Tab and Stan for today, Brother Matt Ryan, who is going to be here this evening. So he will be spending the year with us, and he'll be doing different ministries here, including entering the school, being a part of our parish community. He knows someone that we all know here. Remember Father Colin King, who's now in Jamaica, so we're from the same community. So it's a great pleasure to have your brother here with us as we call him. So welcome to our parish community. And we also have this evening another Franciscan brother, Neil, who is also here today. So we just want to say, Brother Neil, welcome to St. Paul of Vegas. Thank you for being here. In the bulletin this weekend, there's a number of flyers. You'll also see inside the bulletin that there is an envelope for the second collection, which is meant to support the Christians in the Holy Land. So normally this is the collection that would have been taken on Good Friday, but most of the second collections from March, April, May, and June are being rescheduled for the remainder of this calendar year. So if you're able, to do something to support the Christians in the Holy Land with the Good Friday collection, just feel free to drop something in the envelope and put it there with the other collection as you're on your way out of the church. You know, we're in the process of renewing my church. So I hope that doesn't come as a surprise to anybody here at Mass today. But we have a great team that's helping lead us through what's right now the phase we're in is called discernment and decisions. And so with St. Clotilde and St. Dorothy, we're discerning what our future will look like as the Catholic community here in Chatham and Park Manor. So the team that is a part of helping lead us through the discernment process is composed of Vanessa Smiley and Tanya Golden and Tierra Yarborough and Anthony Edmund. And so I just ask you to pray for each of them as they take on this important leadership responsibility in our parish community. This morning they are actually at St. Clotilde's, worshiping with the community there and also the other team members from St. Dorothy and St. Clotilde. Next weekend the teams will be over at St. Dorothy's for their Sunday worship, and then on October 4th, the teams will be with us here at St. Paul Vegas. It's called the Summer Discovery Series. It's a way for the teams to get to know the communities, to maybe visit churches that they've never been in, and to really have an opportunity to pray in each of our parishes. So in the bulletin this weekend, we've republished what Renew My Church is about, what this call of discipleship is meant to be about. So I really encourage you to take the time to reread that if you need to visit our parish website or to visit the Archdiocese website to learn more about Renew My Church. What will happen? We had our first meeting of our teams this past Wednesday evening. It was an opportunity for us to hear from one another, learn about each other, talk about our hopes and our fears as we begin the Renew My Church process. October 7th will be the next team meeting for the three grouping teams for each of the parishes. So over the course of now until about the end of December, we have something like 8 or 9 meetings that those 4 leaders of our parish will be a part of. So I ask you to pray for them because they're making a huge commitment of time, of their own talents, their own energy, to really help lead us in this moment. So I see that Tierra's back from Mass at St. Clotilde, so we were just talking about you, Tierra, so we're grateful that you're a part of that. So please pray for them and continue to learn more about our church. We also see a flyer in the bulletin that as we continue to use more technology, as we become more digital as a parish, I know that there might be some folks here in church that need a little bit of help learning more about computers. Maybe this does it, like you're on Facebook now or things are going well, would you like to take it up a notch? You can feel free to reach out to Adam Peterson, director of community outreach, or Tommy Wolf. time inside of your limited, or if it's on the blue card or something. Lord Jesus, you speak to us today as you spoke to holy men and women who have gone before us. In every age and in our own time, you call to us and say, "Be my church." Pour out the gift of your Holy Spirit upon us, and so enable us to hear you clearly, to listen to each other attentively, to imagine our future boldly, to discern your direction wisely, to persevere in your holy will courageously, to stay together in your charity, to surrender our own plans readily, to embrace the greater good, to hand out your gifts to future generations. May we remain in the holy company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the apostles, and all the saints. May their example and presence inspire us with patient confidence in the work of your grace. We ask this of you who live and reign with the Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. The Lord be with you.